Welcome to MedVids Made Simple. In this video, we're going to see about anatomy of the heart. Heart is a hollow muscular organ. It pumps the oxygenated blood to the whole body. It has got four chambers, the right and left atrium, the right and left ventricles. The heart has got four surfaces, the anterior sternocostal surface, the inferior diaphragmatic surface, the left pulmonary surface and right pulmonary surface. Also, it has got an apex and a base, also known as the posterior surface. The apex is formed by tip of the left ventricle. Now let's see the anterior surface of the heart. In this picture you can see that most of the anterior surface of the heart is formed by right ventricle, which is marked as RV in this picture, and parts of right atrium marked as RA, left atrium marked as LA and left ventricle marked as LV. You can also see the major vessels in this picture. Now let's see the base and inferior surface of the heart. In this picture we can see that most of the base of the heart is formed by left atrium and a part of right atrium. Most of the inferior surface is formed by left ventricle and a part of right ventricle. Let's see the borders of the heart. The heart has got an upper border, a right border, a left border and an inferior border. The grooves of sulci. First one is the coronary sulcus, which is also known as the atrioventricular sulcus, which separates the atrium from the ventricles. Second one is the interventricular sulcus, which is further divided into anterior and posterior interventricular sulcus. These divide the right ventricle from the left ventricle. Third one is the interatrial sulcus, which is faintly visible. It divides the right atrium from the left atrium. The same thing known as crux. Crux is the point where the posterior interventricular sulcus meets the posterior atrioventricular sulcus. Now in this picture, you can see that the anterior interventricular sulcus separates the right ventricle from the left ventricle. And you can also see that the right anterior coronary sulcus is present below the right atrium and the left anterior coronary sulcus is present below the left atrium. In the posterior aspect, you can see that the posterior coronary sulcus separates the atrium from the ventricles. And a line which is present between the left ventricle and right ventricle, which is the posterior interventricular sulcus. Now let's see about the individual chambers of the heart. First, right atrium. It receives deoxygenated blood via superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. It pumps it into right ventricles via the tricuspid valve. It forms a part of anterior surface of the heart and base of the heart. Now there are a few openings in the wall of right atrium. Superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, coronary sinus, anterior cardiac veins and right marginal vein opens into the right atrium. There's something known as sulcus terminalis, which is seen on the wall of right atrium. This is a vertical groove which extends between the superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. This is formed due to internal muscular ridges which are present inside the right atrium, which are known as crista terminalis. The sinoatrial node or SI node, which is the primary pacemaker of the heart, is situated in the upper part of the sulcus. The internal features of right atrium. First, let's see about the smooth posterior part. The major veins such as the superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, coronary sinus, opens into this part, the rough anterior part. This is formed by musculi pectinati, which are transverse muscular ridges which make this part rough. Now interatrial septum. This is the septum which divides the right atrium from the left atrium. This has got something known as fossa ovalis and limbus fossa ovalis, which surrounds it. These are embryological remnants. There's something known as foramen ovale, which is a slit-like opening between the fossa ovalis and limbus fossa ovalis. Normally, this foramen occludes after birth, but sometimes this may persist, and this may need some form of intervention. Now let's see about the right ventricle. The right ventricle receives the blood from deoxygenated blood from right atrium. This then pumps the blood to the lungs via the pulmonary trunk. The right ventricle forms a large part of the anterior surface of the heart, as shown previously in the figure, and it also forms a part of the inferior surface of the heart. Now there's something known as trabeculae carnei, which are nothing but muscular ridges. The types are ridges, bridges, and papillary muscles, which are also known as pillars. The important thing is papillary muscles. What are papillary muscles? What do? They connect the cusps of the tricuspid valves to the ventricular valve and keeps them patent. There's something known as moderated band in the right ventricle. This extends from the ventricular septum to the anterior papillary muscle. What does this contain? This contains the right branch of AV bundle. Now let's see about left atrium. Left atrium receives the oxygenated blood from the lungs via four pulmonary veins, which drain on the posterior surface. The left atrium then pumps the blood into left ventricle via the bicuspid valve, also known as the mitral valve. The left atrium forms a part of the anterior surface, left surface, and base of the heart. Let's see about left ventricle. The left ventricle pumps the oxygenated blood received from left atrium into the aorta via the aortic or semilunar valve. The left ventricle wall is more thicker than the right ventricle wall. If you compare the ratio between the left ventricle and right ventricle wall thickness, it is about 3:1. The left ventricle forms the apex, anterior surface, left surface, and most of the inferior surface. Trabeculae carnei are also present in the lower part of the left ventricle, making it rough. As said earlier, papillary muscles are also present in left ventricle, and there are two, anterior and posterior. Chorda tendineae are nothing but the extension between the papillary muscles and the valves. They keep the valves patent. They attach the cusps of mitral valve to the papillary muscles and keeps the valves patent. Now let's see about the valves of the heart. This is very important. What do? They provide unidirectional flow of blood and they prevent regurgitation of blood back. There are two atrioventricular valves, bicuspid valve, also known as mitral valve, and tricuspid valve. There are two semilunar valves, aortic valve and pulmonary valve. How are these cusps formed? The cusps are formed by folds of endocardium containing a layer of fibrous tissue inside them. Now let's see about atrioventricular valves. They're surrounded by fibrous ring to which the cusps are attached. The cusps have an atrial surface which faces the atrium, it is smooth, and the ventricular surface which faces the ventricles, and it is rough due to the attachment of chorda tendineae, as told earlier. Chorda tendineae is attached to the papillary muscles and to the cusps to keep it patent. Let's see about the semilunar valves. The semilunar valves has got semilunar shaped cusps, thus they got their name. And there is no fibrous ring surrounding the cusps as told in atrioventricular valve. There are three cusps in each semilunar valve. Now let's see about the blood supply of the heart, starting from arterial supply. First, artery supplying the heart is right coronary artery, which is derived from anterior aortic sinus of the aorta. Second is the left coronary artery, which is derived from left posterior aortic sinus of aorta. And there's something known as cardiac dominance. You should know that about 90% of the cases, it is right side dominant. What's that? It is based on the artery, which gives a branch. Known as the posterior interventricular branch. That artery is called the dominant artery. In most of the cases, in 90% of the cases, the right coronary artery gives the posterior interventricular branch, so it is branded as right dominant. Let's see about the venous drainage of the heart. Most of the venous drainage of the heart is by the coronary sinus, which is situated in the posterior wall, which opens into the posterior wall of right atrium. It is situated in the posterior coronary sulcus. It receives many tributaries, includes great cardiac vein, middle cardiac vein, small cardiac vein, right marginal vein. And there are anterior cardiac veins which drains into the anterior wall of the right atrium. And there are small veins known as venae cordis minimae. Now, the nerve supply of the heart. The nerve supply of the heart. Heart has got full autonomic nervous system supply. The parasympathetic division is cardioinhibitory. It slows down the heart rate. It is derived from vagus nerve. The sympathetic division is cardioacceleratory. It increases the heart rate. It is derived from upper 4 to 5 thoracic segments. Now these two join to form cardiac plexuses, which are classified into superficial and deep, and supply the heart. Majority is by parasympathetic supply. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel MedVidsMadeSimple. Please comment below to let us know what videos you want in the future. Please follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram and Google+. Please support us by donating on Patreon. Thank you.